Hey, brothers and sisters, I had to restart this video. I started to do the prayer for people, and the first name I prayed for was Elisa Maria F. And I got a word for you. I don't want to make it public. I'm going to write it down here before I forget, but I don't think I will. This is okay, let me write that down. Sister Lisa Maria F. I'm trying to find your email, or if you message me on YouTube, I'm not sure. Or Facebook. Maybe. I can't remember because it's been a couple days ago, whatever. Can you please contact me and I will give you this word in private? So praise the Lord for that. I ask you guys to pray. I'm going to try again. I stopped in the video because that one was throwing me for a loop de loop. And I couldn't move on, so I had to start over again. Let's try again. Ask your brothers and sisters to pray in agreement with me, because the Lord is above space and time. Your prayer, even if it's next week or 10 years from now, the Lord knew you was going to pray in agreement with me on this video, and it will bring a blessing to the persons we're praying for. So let's pray, brothers and sisters. Let's go with Kelly W. Kelly W. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we just come in agreement and pray for Kelly W. Hallelujah. And the word I get from the Lord is righteousness exalts a nation. Hallelujah. A Holy Spirit goes before a fall or before destruction. I hear that right now. You know, pride goes before a fall, a Holy Spirit before destruction. That's what I also hear. And righteousness exalts a nation. That's what I hear. Kelly W. Rebecca H. Let's pray for Rebecca H. right now, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. We pray for Rebecca H. right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God. I speak grace and mercy and peace unto you from the Lord our God, the Father, and His Son, Jesus Christ, who has blessed you with all blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Let the will of God be done, for His grace is sufficient for you. It's like dealing with your mom. The grace is sufficient for thee. His grace is sufficient for your mom. I speak right now blessings and honor and glory from the God Most High, Creator of heaven and earth. And Lord, just tell me, let this be a lesson unto you. Let this be a lesson unto you. Whatever that is, the Lord wants you to get a lesson out of this, sister Rebecca, and for your mom, maybe it's that's for her, or that part's for you, and the other part is for her. His grace is sufficient for her. Now, Shannon B. Shannon B. right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord God, we come in agreement and pray for Shannon B. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I hear something about the web, like I guess like the internet, the web. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and glory, or it could be, you know, like a web, and being entangled in a web. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and glory in the name of Jesus. I believe it's a web of deceit. Shannon B., there's a web of deceit. The Lord is speaking to me about a web of deceit. Maybe it's from the web also. The Lord will play on words too. You know, like there's a web of deceit from the web, from the internet. Maybe you've been watching videos that is deceit. Or the Lord, there's... The Lord wants you to make videos to dispel the deceit. I don't know. I give you the praise and glory, Father, in the name of Jesus. Avina F.D. Avina F.D. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, we come in agreement and pray for Avina F.D. And I speak right now in the name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. Faith comes by hearing, hearing by the word of God. O ye of little faith, why have you doubted, the Lord is saying. Oh, ye of little faith, why have you doubted? So the Lord spoke to Peter when he started to sink. The Lord saved him when Peter walked on the water. Lots of people don't know. Unless you've read the Gospels, lots of people haven't read the Gospels. Everybody talks about Jesus walking on the water. Peter walked on the water too when the Lord called him out. Then Peter began to sink, and then he yelled, Lord, save me, which is, you know, people, you know, will dog out Peter for sinking. No, none of the other disciples got out of the boat, number one. Number two, Peter had enough sense to say, Lord, save me. When he started to sink. You know, I'm just thinking about it now. As the Lord is just speaking to me. I never thought about this before. Think about this. Peter fell when he denied the Lord three times. And obviously he cried out for help. He wept bitterly. He obviously cried out for help. And the Lord restored him. just like him sinking in the water was a metaphor. You know, he went in there. Well, he followed Jesus. All the rest of the disciples ran away except for John, because John was the youngest. He was just like a teenager. Nobody was going to mess with him anyway. He was like a kid. And number two, he was actually a relative or a friend of the high priest, or he was a relative of the high priest. I can't remember. He's a friend of the high priest's family. So he was like, could go there because he knew those people. So the rest of the disciples ran away. Strike the shepherd and the sheep will scatter. But Peter had the boldness to try to follow Jesus, as he said. He told Jesus, I'll go with you everywhere you go. I'm willing to die with you. And that's when Jesus said, are you really? So I was saying to you before before the rooster crows three times, you'll deny me thrice. So people always talk about that, but they don't have they don't think about how the fact that Peter had the boldness not to run away like the rest of them did. Peter had the boldness to step on water, and he sank. And when his lack of faith, he sank, and then the Lord lifted him up because he cried out for help. Same thing when he was walking on the water by walking in. This, I can do a whole sermon on this. I've never even thought of this before. That's the miracle of the working of the Holy Spirit, brothers and sisters, giving you unction. So if you see this, you'll be blessed by that. I am too, because I never thought about this. And then when Peter went into the temple, as I said, he had the boldness to go to the high priest's house, Caiaphas' house. He had the boldness to go in there. Then he denied the Lord three times, just like when he sank in the water. He ran out and wept bitterly, but yet the Lord restored him. Right, brothers and sisters? Anyway, as a matter of fact, he was restored by the Lord when he was fishing without his clothes on, when he knew it was the Lord calling them to the shore after he was resurrected. Peter dove into the water again and swam to shore as quick as he could to get to the Lord. All right, I could keep going on and on about it too. The Lord asked him three times. He denied the Lord three times. The Lord asked him three times, do you love me? Let's go. That's Avina FD that I just gave that to. Oh, you have little faith. Louisa G. L-U-I-S-A-G. Louisa G. Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, we come together, Lord God, and we just pray for Louisa G. Right now I declare victory, victory, victory in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, that God is the Most High God, creator of heaven and earth, the Redeemer. The Lord says that he wants you to know him as the Redeemer. He is the Redeemer. He is the Redeemer. Louisa G., the Lord is the Redeemer. He redeems people. He purchased us back. You know, we've been sold into slavery by Adam and Eve. We're slaves to sin. Jesus said we are slaves to sin. And the Lord has redeemed us from the curse of the law. He has redeemed us from the curse of the law. It's coming up in my spirit right now. We are not under the law. We are not saved by works. But by grace are you saved through faith, not by works, lest any man should boast. The Lord has redeemed you from the curse of the law, the Bible says. That's obviously something that's struggling in your mind, or you have a situation, you know, in your mind, or someone in your family, you got a problem there with trying to follow the law. We've been set free from the law of sin and death. I'm talking about the law of Moses. Clearly taught throughout the New Testament. Rebecca L. We did a Rebecca H. This is Rebecca L. Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, we come together and pray for Rebecca L. We pray victory and deliverance. I hear again about deliverance. I said redemption. That's deliverance. The Lord is saying he's sending the spirit of deliverance for you in Jesus' name. Rebecca L., it's the spirit of deliverance. Deliverance. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Deliverance from... I can't say what the Lord has shown me about addictions and stuff. The Lord has told me about a deliverance from sexual immorality. Not necessarily mean for you, Rebecca L. I mean, people ask me for a word, I just have to get what comes out of my mouth. Sexual immorality could be for one of your family members. Not necessarily for you, sister, I don't know. But I hear sexual immorality, deliverance from sexual sin. In Jesus' name right now, we declare it. We come in agreement. We decree it in Jesus' name. Right now, Robert S., Robert S. We pray for Robert S., Brother Robert S., right now in the name of Jesus Christ. And I hear the song, Love Lifted Me, when nothing else would do. Love lifted me. He lifted me. You know, the love of the Lord would lift you out of the miry clay. The love of the Lord has lifted you, or will lift you. That's the word of the Lord for you. The song, Love Lifted Me. Go look it up and listen to it. If you don't know it, Robert S. Stephen P. We come in agreement, brothers and sisters, right now in the name of Jesus Christ to pray for Stephen P. And Father, we ask, Lord, for your blessings. Let God be exalted and Satan be defeated in Jesus Christ as Lord. Stephen P., God is exalted. Satan is defeated in Jesus Christ as Lord. Hallelujah. For the victory and the love of the Lord endureth forever. The love of the Lord endureth forever. Stephen P., victory is mine. I keep hearing that song. It's an old spiritual song. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is mine. That's right there for you, Stephen P. H-E-N-A-B-E-L-S. Hannibal S. Hannibal S. Almost like Hannibal. Hannibal S. Right now, Father, we come in agreement and pray for Hannibal S. In the name of Jesus right now, Lord, we speak victory, honor, and glory and power unto your holy name, Lord God. Right now, I speak and declare of Mount Zion. We have come to Mount Zion. We have not come to the mountain that cannot be touched. But we've come to Mount Zion, as Hebrews chapter 12, to the church of the firstborn, where God is, where the holy angels are. It's heaven. Mount Zion is the resting place of the church on Mount Zion. Hebrews chapter 12, that's the text of what the Lord wants you to look at. We don't come to the mountain Horeb there where Moses received the Ten Commandments, but we come to Mount Zion. That's what the Lord wants you to look at. Hannibal S. Rebecca H. I already did a Rebecca H. This is already twice. I got you on here twice. Rebecca H. I already did you. Lillian K. Lillian K. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, God Most High, Creator of heaven and earth, Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus, your only begotten Son. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I hear the word switchblade. Now, you know, there's a movie called The Cross and the Switchblade about the life of David Wilkerson. You know, Pat Boone plays in that movie. They made, which I've seen that movie late at night, Christian television in the middle of the night when I first became a pastor. I used to sit up and watch all these movies, and I saw The Cross and the Switchblade, the true story of how the Lord used David Wilkerson to bring peace among the gangs of New York, like in the 60s there, late 50s, early 60s. Lady Young K, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, we give the Lord all the praise and honor. We lift you up to the Lord, Lillian K, right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Father, I ask you, Lord God, to move in the life of Lillian K, Lord. We ask, Lord, for you to pour out your Spirit upon Lillian K right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And I just speak and declare right now that the Lord is the good shepherd. Hallelujah. That the Lord watches over his flock. That the Lord neither slumbers nor sleeps. That the Lord watches over his people. Hallelujah. He's the good shepherd. And I see the Lord with his shepherd's rod looking out over his sheep like a shepherd in the middle of the night. I see the Lord keeping watch over his sheep. For the Lord of Israel neither slumbers nor sleeps. The Lord will protect you and deliver you, hallelujah, from the power of the enemy is defeated in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah, Lillian. Drend Lee. D-R-E-N-D or B-R-E-N-D. Lee. Like Brend or Drend Lee. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, Lord, I ask you to help me with my handwriting, Lord. Father, we pray for Drend or Brend Lee. Right now in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we speak your blessings. We speak wisdom of God Most High. A spirit of wisdom, the Lord is telling me, a spirit of wisdom to come upon you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Lee. That the wisdom, the wind of the wisdom of the Most High God blow upon you in Jesus' name. Right now, hallelujah. And the Lord is just quoting from me from that text what he spoke to in John chapter 3 to Nicodemus. You know, the wind blows where it wants and you see the effects of the wind, but you cannot see the wind. Such is the work of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. So you can see the effects of the Holy Spirit, even though you can't see the Holy Spirit himself, just like the wind. Hallelujah. The wind is at your feet. The wind is under your feet and the wind is at your back, Lee. And go forward in the wind of God. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit. Hallelujah in Jesus' name. Sam F. Sam F. Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, we come in agreement for Sam F. Hallelujah. And I hear, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. Sam F. Hallelujah. Be a light. Be a light in this world. Be a light unto the Gentiles. Hallelujah. I hear in my spirit from the Lord. Be a light. Be a light. In other words, show the light of the Lord to the world. That's what the Lord wants you to do. Let's see if I want to keep going. Like I said, Lisa Marie F., you have got to message me. I don't have time, but I can if I have to search through. There's something that needs to be divulged or will be divulged or needs to be divulged. A situation of a crime that has happened and it will be divulged or it needs to be divulged. Maybe you know about this crime and the Lord wants you to divulge it. Or it's about to be divulged and you're going to find out about it. Somebody in your family or whatever. About a crime. And I'll tell you what it is if you message me, Lisa Marie F. Lindy K. Lindy K. Let's come in agreement. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Lindy K. The Lord is telling me to tell you to read your Bible, read the Word daily. Give us this, Lord, our daily bread. Read the Bible. Meditate on it day and night. Let it not depart before your eyes, Lindy K. Do not let the Word of God depart before your eyes. This is what the Lord spoke to Joshua. Joshua chapter 1. Julia S. Hallelujah. Julia S. We come in agreement and pray for Julia S. right now in the name of Jesus. Julia S. I hear the song, there's a song, Peace in the Valley. The song I hear is Peace in the Valley. There will be peace in the valley for me someday. There'll be no sorrow, no sadness. There'll be peace in the valley for me someday. That's the song I hear for you, Julia S. Peace in the Valley. So you must be in a valley, and the Lord is going to give you peace while you're in a valley. The Lord is with thee. They'll walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I will fear no evil. But of course, not necessarily saying that it's death. I want to say that you're in a valley in your life. You know, valley can be depression. A valley can be, you know, just a hard time financially, anything. It's a valley. The Lord will give you peace in that valley. There's peace in the valley for you, Julia C. Let's pray in agreement right now. Father, we come in agreement right now. Pray for Julia C. Julia S. We lift her up to you, Father, in the name of Jesus. We declare right now your spirit of peace to overtake. I release in Jesus' name by the authority of the Most High God. As a servant of the Most High God, I release the anointing that's in me, the spirit of peace, to be upon Julia S. right now in Jesus' name. We call those things that are not as if they are. I speak peace like a river in the life of Julia S. right now. I release it and speak it and decree it and declare it in Jesus' name. I ask you guys to come in agreement with me. Whatever we bind on earth will be bound in heaven. What we loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Right now, let's loose a river of peace on Julia S. right now. We come in agreement and release a river of peace over the life of Julia S. in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God in the highest. The Lord wants you to begin to praise Him, Julia S. Praise Him, glory to God in the highest, peace on earth and goodwill toward all men. That's not only for the nativity, that's not only for the manger scene, that's not only for the shepherds in the guarding the sheep in the fields of Bethlehem but at the night of the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, but it's for the whole church. It's the message to God for mankind. That's the gospel. Peace on earth, glory to God in the highest, peace on earth and goodwill toward all men. That's the message of the gospel. God sent His peace, the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. Hallelujah. I better stop right now, brothers and sisters. I'm going to stop right now. And I'm going to mark this off because I did not do this. I still got a pretty good list. Just be patient, brothers and sisters, and I'll try to get to you when I can. God bless.